A 39-year-old male came to the office because he was concerned the left side of his face was getting bigger. This turned out to be significantly more serious than some mild facial swelling. Check out the second video in this multi-part case today on The Open Reduction. Welcome to The Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're continuing the case I presented in this previous video. Quick recap, this patient is a 39-year-old male who came to my office because of a growth in his left lower jaw. I performed an exam and obtained a cone beam CT. There is an enormous radiolucency in the left mandible extending from the body up to the condyle. It is causing expansion and destruction of the bone. The differential on this lesion includes an odontogenic keratocyst, an amoeblastoma, a central giant cell granuloma, and a myxoma. I biopsied this lesion in the last video and sent the tissue to the pathologist. The pathology on this came back as an amoeblastoma. Amoeblasts are cells that are present during tooth development. They're responsible for enamel production. They deposit enamel on the developing tooth after the dentin formation is complete, courtesy of the odontoblasts, a different type of cell involved in tooth development. Amoeblasts typically die once the tooth is developed and erupted, but sometimes they remain and cause pathology. Amoeblastomas are benign tumors, but they are locally destructive and can cause significant damage, as in this tumor. They are much more likely to appear in the mandible than the maxilla, and the posterior mandible is the most common location. Patients are usually between the age of 20 to 40. Amoeblastomas are rarely malignant lesions, but they can be. Less than 1% of amoeblastomas are malignant. This patient has lost most of his left mandible to this lesion, and this is a recurrence. He was treated with an enucleation back in 2013. And now this tumor has returned much worse than before. Unfortunately, this means this patient will require a large resection. This tumor extends too far superiorly to salvage the condyle, so the joint will need to be removed as well. This will leave this patient with an enormous defect. Thankfully, there's a great option to replace this patient's jaw. I am going to work with a plastic reconstructive surgeon on this case. I will perform the removal of this tumor and placement of a reconstruction plate to his native mandible. While I am doing this, the plastic surgeon will be harvesting tissue from a different area of his body. The question is, where can we acquire enough bone to repair a defect of this size? The answer is the fibula, one of the bones in the lower leg. The plastic surgeon is able to harvest a large portion of the fibula along with the soft tissue pedicle that includes an artery and a vein. This bone needs to have an immediate blood supply in order to survive, so the plastic surgeon will tie the artery and vein into the vessels of the neck. This requires a microscope and amazing surgical skill. We perform an online virtual surgery in preparation for this case. We are able to determine where to resect this tumor and then design the shape and position of the reconstruction plate. The medical modeling company will also create custom cutting guides so I know exactly where to make the cuts. We also incorporate his fibula into this virtual surgery, and the plastic surgeon is provided with cutting guides also. We will contour the fibula to recreate the natural contour of his jaw as much as possible. This is an enormous case that is technically extremely difficult. There will be two surgical teams working in harmony, and this is an all-day case. The next video will be the complete surgery. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and stay tuned to the channel for the next video, the most rewarding and challenging OMFS case you'll ever see. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.